Christina, you are Professor Elma. You are our next guest speaker, and I'm looking forward to hearing about your journalistic process and the projects that you've worked on.
So you might now see my short introduction, but because you have introduced myself, you have introduced me. So I just wanted to say that I just recently switched from practical journalism to science. And now have the honor of teaching and researching digital and data journalism in Dortmund. So this input will mostly focus on the challenges that I came across during my practical time in journalism and that I think are super interesting and can tell us quite much about the state of the media and also where to focus on in journalism education, for example, and also in media companies. So I'd first like to start with data journalism, which is the field where I've been working on in the last years. And I think we have quite well established data teams in many newsrooms right now and also lots of work opportunities for data journalists. And also, of course, in the pandemic, we have seen those teams really producing quite interesting and also really important and relevant content. But the next step would be to really much more and better interlock the investigation methods of these data journalistic teams and also the investigation teams and the established journalists in other teams and in other fields. So this is one example where this really went quite well at Der Spiegel with a team out of data journalists and investigative journalists. But in the end, I think we will have to bring the competencies of data journalism much more into the mainstream and at the same time, of course, deepen their knowledge of data wrangling and also for more complex methods. So this is really, really a big step that I think we have to take. The second challenge is one that I found in editorial development. What you can see right here, these are persona profiles that we have produced at Der Spiegel and that we have also printed on postcards and distributed to every journalist in the newsroom so that they could really remember the design thinking workshops and the persona workshops they did in our relaunch project in 2019. And this worked out quite well, so I was quite impressed with the workshops, but in the end I have to say that in the everyday work in the newsroom, the empathic and also the perspective of the users is lost far too quickly. And I think we have to start quite early and also anchor this topic in the mindset at a very early stage, for example, in journalism education. And I can see this in my own journalistic format development classes here at the university, where I see that the students are so open-minded, and for them, it's not hard to switch perspectives and to work user-centric in a user-centric way. So this is really something that we should foster in the early years. The third topic is AI in journalism. I think it's one of the biggest challenges right now to really keep our technical infrastructure up to date and to integrate new tools and new technologies like these AI systems into our workflows. This is one example from Der Spiegel as well. This is a tool that supports you within the content management system to link to internal sites, which is something that we did mainly for SEO purposes. And implementing that was quite a ride, I have to admit, because in the end, we saw that most of the colleagues did not really understand what this AI tool can do and what it can't do, and also where it has its limits naturally. And the second thing is that we really didn't have a clearly defined workflow, which is the thing that I think we have to really change in every newsroom. So I think we both need the literacy of how those tools work and what they can do and what they can't and how they gain their knowledge, but also a bigger workflow awareness in the newsrooms. This would also be quite helpful. And this is the last slide that you have already looked at before. This is about algorithmic accountability reporting, and I think this is also a field that journalism has to tackle much more intensively in the future. It's a critical field for investigative journalists, and this example here shows that we really need a much bigger transparency for that and a bigger public awareness that we need these data. Points. For example, here we have conducted a research and an investigation on the Schufa algorithm of Germany's most important and biggest credit scoring agency. And we could do so only with the help of crowdsourcing, with data donations by, I think, 2,800 people who gave us their Schufa reports. And of course, you could do this in another quality and on a bigger scale if you would have a transparency where journalists could really access these data sets in a form and also do investigations with them. So this is a field that I would also say that we need more knowledge about how algorithms work and what questions journalists should ask. But also, we need a much bigger public awareness so that we can foster the transparency. And this is all I wanted to say for now. Sorry for the technical problems. And yeah, really looking forward to discussing these topics with you all.
Thank you so much, Christina. You've mentioned the students and their openness to try out, to experiment with new formats. How would you rate the willingness at Der Spiegel regarding not only trying out and experimenting, but actually implementing new tools and new technologies like AI? How would you rate that, if you can, even in general?
It's a hard question, of course, to answer, but I think it depends who you ask. I mean, if you talk to the people in the newsroom, you have to acknowledge, I would say, that they really work in a quite innovative way every day if they produce new contents and when they really are dealing with new challenges every day. And it's sometimes really hard to implement new workflows and new tools in these workflows. But on the other hand side, when we look at the product development, editorial development teams, for example, of course, they are all keen to really bring new tools and new contents also into the newsroom. So this is, I think it depends. But I would also say that it's quite hard in a daily driven newsroom to really put in something new from outside.
And I think that's a perfect transition to our next guest speaker.